Welcome back, guys, to another video. Let's talk about Tesla, because right now we have a lot of big news. You got some sales coming up, just a Cybertruck and much, much more. 2020 wasn't really a good year for most companies out there. Tesla did phenomenal in 2020, despite the whole pandemic situation, which caused a lot of luxury car manufacturers to go down in sales. Tesla, on the other hand, did really, really well, and it was actually Tesla's year. 2020 was pretty phenomenal. Brand new autopilot systems, new sales, the increase of gigafactories, but 2021 will be an even bigger year, since 2020, in my opinion, was just the beginning and was setting up for a phenomenal next year, 2021, which the pandemic, it's already slowly going down, which is a good thing in most countries around the world. You also have a bunch of gigafactories popping up, and it's looking pretty good. So first thing is, Tesla's Model Y sales are incredible. I can't tell you how many people like the Model Ys, and more people are buying it ever than before. In my city alone, we don't really have that many people, but I've been seeing more Model Y cars than the Model 3 cars. And as many as 7 in every 10 cars sold by Tesla here in the United States, the Model Ys are the most popular cars. Yes, 7 out of 10 Tesla cars sold in the US are Model Ys. And Tesla was right about the Model Ys will be outdoing the Model 3s, the S's and the X's all combined together. And this electric crossover was launched in March 2020. And the moment I saw it, I thought it was a really phenomenal car. It looked really, really good. And at first, some people thought it was kind of weird, but everyone slowly got into it. Because the Model Ys were a hybrid between the Model 3s and the Model X's. A lot of people don't have enough money to purchase the Model X, and some people don't like the massive size. Some people don't like the Model 3s, which is a little bit too small. So they opt in for the Model Y, which is a just right size, fully electric with autopilot if you want to, and it's pretty cheap. It's not as expensive as most luxury vehicles out there. So this is why the Model Ys are performing this well, and 7 in 10 Tesla vehicles, once again, that are sold in the US are Model Ys. If you go overseas and check out the Shanghai Gigafactory, it's already producing the Tesla Model 3s, which are one of the most popular vehicles in China. A lot of people have this really big appetite and craze for electric vehicles, and now the Shanghai Gigafactory 2 pretty much already finished. It's already producing the Tesla Model Ys, and they already have a few of the Tesla Model Ys lined up outside the Shanghai Gigafactory 2, and we'll be seeing it being fully operational in 2021. And what the rumors are saying that we should be expecting first deliveries to Chinese customers over there around maybe quarter two of 2021. They're still under production. There's only a few of the models being built, but it's honestly a pretty interesting thing to look at. If you check out NIO's biggest competitor in China, which is NIO, the NIO EC6 is a pretty phenomenal vehicle. It's also a crossover, and a good chunk of NIO sales recently are the crossovers. And if you check out their sales, in November, they sold roughly 5,300 vehicles. The NIO crossover EC6 was one of the best-selling crossover vehicles ever. That's fully electric. So Tesla knows that here in the US, the Model Ys are so popular, but in China, the Model Ys will be even more popular. And this is what they're banking on. This is why they spent even more money in upgrading the size of the Shanghai Gigafactory 2 to produce the Model Ys. On top of that, even better news is it will be fully operational January of 2021, which is less than a couple months away. Now, we also had the Berlin Gigafactory that's under construction. Now, it wouldn't be finishing up until the summer or fall of 2021, but the Shanghai Gigafactory will be producing the Model 3s and the Model Ys, which is small enough to be driven in most European roads, highways, and also parking garages. If you have ordered the Cybertruck, well, these vehicles will be coming out very, very soon. Now, Tesla unveiled the Cybertruck like several months ago. It wasn't really a good impression, especially both the glasses broke after he threw that metal ball. But Tesla is rumored to be getting this Cybertruck steel from a brand new $1.7 billion factory in Texas. So far, Tesla might be having to deal with Steel Dynamics to supply all the steel for the Cybertruck EV. Because if you check out the Cybertruck's exoskeleton, it's really metal heavy. So you're going to be needing a ton of good metal, especially how Musk has said that this is the best steel they can make. And this is the steel that's used in the Starship rocket. So at this current moment, let's just see what happens. Because currently, this is a massive factory. A lot of really great jobs are popping up in Texas. And this Cybertruck, in my opinion, will be selling really, really well. It's really big. It's really hefty. You could put a lot of stuff behind it. And Tesla is already trying to order several steel exoskeletons from Steel Dynamics. That's what the rumors are. But I read several articles, several tweets, and this is most likely going to happen. Last but not least is the Shanghai Gigafactory 2. They will be producing the Model Ys, and these will be the best-selling EVs in China. Keep in mind that the electric charging stations in China from Tesla is pretty lousy. All right, there's not that many charging stations in major Chinese highways, and there's not a lot of charging stations in Chinese cities either. This is why a lot of consumers over there who buy Teslas sometimes have to utilize third-party charging stations. Now, if Tesla doesn't like this and they know it, they want to create a really good cult following and good base of consumers. So now they're opening up a brand new gigafactory that specifically makes Tesla superchargers. Yes, you usually think when they open a gigafactory, it's supposed to be making cars or batteries, but they're opening up a brand new factory that strictly only makes Tesla superchargers. Now, these superchargers will be made and deployed around the Chinese highways and the cities. On top of that, it will be making roughly 10,000 superchargers per year. So after a couple years, especially after everyone started buying the Model Ys and Model 3s, you will be having roughly 10,000 to 30,000 Tesla superchargers around major roads and highways. This just shows you that Tesla really does care about consumers, and they know Tesla in China is going to be a really big deal in the next few years, so they will be deploying more superchargers. Now, you don't really see other companies doing this. Volkswagen, BMW, Mercedes have little to no plans of making any sort of charging stations around the globe. Volkswagen, for example, are relying on third-party companies here in the US like Blink Charging and ChargePoint instead of making their own charging stations. Most companies are going for that instead of making their own charging station network, which is really expensive and it takes a lot of time. And Tesla supercharger network took them years and years to perfect. And this is why they have so many locations. This is why I feel like Tesla is easily 3 to 5 years ahead of its competition. So that's about it, guys. Thanks for watching. Comment below. We're getting a decent amount of news from Tesla, especially the autopilot system. Now, if you're one of the few guys that got the FSD beta, you should be expecting some sort of a wider release within a couple months. Now, Tesla's rumored to be announcing a wider release full self-driving beta software to all of their consumers around late December or early January, or maybe the latest February of 2021. So if you're one of the guys who spent so much money buying it, you will be rewarded very, very soon for your patience. And you're also upgrading the software every 5 to 10 days. So 2021, a lot of big things about Tesla. We will be seeing